You okay?
I told you he'd be fine.
Bastards!
Now, now. I just saved your life.
Saved my life? You kidnapped me. You strapped me into that thing.
Animus. It's an animus.
I don't even know you people. Why are you doing this to me?
You have information we need, Mr. Miles.
Information? I'm a bartender, for Christ's sakes. What do you want me to do, teach you how to mix a martini?
We know who you are, what you are.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Don't play coy with me. There isn't time. You're an assassin. And whether you realize it or not, you've got something that my employers want. Locked away in that head of yours.
But I'm not an assassin. Not anymore.
Yes, your file indicated as much. Something about an escape. Most fortunate for us.
What do you want from me?
For you to do as you're told. The Animus will allow us to locate what we need. Once we have it, you'll be free to go.
I am not going back in there.
Then we'll induce a coma and continue our work. When we're done, you'll be left to die. Truth be told, the only reason you're still conscious is because this approach saves us time.
You're insane.
So what is it, Mr. Miles? Live or die? Lie down.
Where am I?
You're inside the Animus.
Which is...
It's a projector that renders genetic memories in three dimensions.
Genetic memory?
Seems you'll need a bit of a tutorial. Very well. We'll start simple. What is a memory, Mr. Miles?
It's the recollection of a past event.
Specific to the individual remembering the event.
Yeah, sure.
What if I told you that the human body not only housed an individual's memory, but the memories of his ancestors as well? Genetic memory, if you will. Migration, hibernation, reproduction. How do animals know when and where to go? What to do?
That's just animal instinct.
Now you're arguing semantics, Mr. Miles. Whatever you call it, the fact remains. These creatures hold knowledge absent the requisite first-hand experience. I've spent the past 30 years trying to understand why. I discovered something most fascinating. Our DNA functions as an archive. It contains not only genetic instructions passed down from previous generations, but memories as well. The memories of our ancestors.
And the Animus lets you decode and read these DNA files.
Precisely.
But there's a problem. This is the specific memory we're trying to access. Unfortunately, when we try and open the memory, your mind withdraws. You lack the confidence to step into your ancestor's body. That's what happened earlier. You got knocked out of the target memory and pushed back to a more stable state.
Why?
It's your subconscious. It's resisting. We've found similar reactions among patients who undergo hypnosis to relive traumatic events. They can't jump directly into the specific memory. They need to be eased in. Even then, there can be problems.
So how do we fix it?
We find a memory you can synchronize with, and we move forward from there. You'll get used to it. This is the closest we can get, so it's where we'll have to start. I'm uploading the tutorial program now.
Wait! There must be another way.
He's experiencing a far better adoption rate than the other subjects.
I'm still pulling him out. He's been in there way too long.
No, not yet. We're still so far from where we need to be.
We shouldn't risk it.
What's another hour or two?
Why don't we discuss this in the conference room? Give Desmond a minute to stretch his legs.
I really don't see the need.
Warren, please.
Fine.
Questioning my authority in front of the prisoner. There's a word for that. I believe it's called insubordination.
And I don't appreciate you trying to kill him. There's a word for that, too. I believe it's called stupid.
Lucy, this isn't my decision. I don't set the deadlines, but I'm smart enough not to challenge them. Do you want to wind up like Layla?
I know the accident has everyone on edge.
Which is why there's no time to coddle him.
If you push him too hard, he'll shut down. And then we'll have nothing.
We have nothing now.
But we will. You just need to have a little faith.
Fine. But thinking of ways to improve its staying power. We can't afford to stop every time the man breaks a sweat. It's bad enough we have to traipse through all of these useless memories.
I'll do what I can.
We're done for today, Mr. Miles. I suggest you return to your room and get some rest.
Gotta say, that's a little creepy, Doc. Waking up to you standing over me. You've been watching me sleep?
We're always watching you. Now get up. We've got a lot of work to do.
Ooh, wonder who I get to kill today.
Don't be so cavalier. Your ancestors almost had the right idea, Mr. Miles. If the deaths of a few people, evil people, no less, could save the lives of thousands more, well, it seems a small sacrifice.
What do you mean, almost?
They didn't go far enough. To use a rather tired analogy, corruption is no different than cancer. Cut out the tumors, but fail to treat the source and, well, you're buying time at best. There's no true change to be had without comprehensive, systemic intervention.
Chemo for the masses.
Education. Re-education, to be more precise. But it's not easy, and it doesn't always take.
Let me guess. You've got a better solution. What is it, then?
Now that would be telling. Out of the machine, Mr. Miles.
What's the matter, Doc?
Miss Stillman is once again insisting I let you rest.
So, feel like telling me who put the stick up his ass?
We have a deadline. 1 week. Well, 6 days now.
Deadline?
I can't talk about it.
Man, put yourself in my shoes. I'm being held hostage by a group of scientists, at least I think you're scientists, and forced to spend all day in some crazy-ass machine. You won't tell me what you're looking for or why you want it, but I'm supposed to be thanking you for keeping me alive. This is so fucked! Sorry, but it is.
What do you want me to do?
Let's see, I don't know. Maybe give me some answers?
I can't. And it's better this way. Safer.
Safer for who?
Both of us.
Hey, you know what? I've got a question I think you can actually answer.
What's up?
Why is it that sometimes the guys in there talk like they're from the future?
The future?
I mean the present. Now, today, whatever.
You've probably noticed that English has become the official language of the Holy Land.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
The Animus is translating speech it deems vital into more modern English, so expect a few anachronisms. I could probably make it more authentic, but you ever read Chaucer?
Who?
Yeah. Definitely not for you.
Can you tell me more about Abstergo? What goes on here? Beyond the whole keeping me prisoner thing.
Abstergo is one of the largest pharmaceutical companies in the world. Their primary focus is antidepressants. There's some information on the computer over there.
But you already said this isn't about testing a drug. So what's the deal?
I don't like where this is going.
So it's safe to assume the Animus is not a part of their public face.
What, you haven't seen the commercials?
Oh my God. She has a sense of humor.
I'm sorry, Desmond. I've got a lot of work to do. Like I said, if you want to know more about the company, take a look at the computer. The telecommunication stuff is particularly interesting.
Let's go, Mr. Miles. Time's wasting.
Where's Lucy?
Oh, don't worry. She'll be with us soon enough.
So why are you doing all this, Doc? What are you hoping to accomplish?
You turn the television on lately? Read the newspaper?
Never cared much for that stuff.
Then, let me sum it up for you. The world's a mess. It's pathetic, really. You've seen it firsthand yourself. 1,000 years between you and your ancestor, and society remains just as barbaric, just as stupid.
And your point is?
Order, Mr. Miles. The world needs order. That is what we're working towards, and that is what you're helping us to achieve.
You expect me to believe you're building a better tomorrow?
That's exactly what we're doing. The human race calls out for direction. They want to know why they're here, what they're meant to do. Well, we're going to tell them. And once they understand how to live their lives, everything will be better.
Better how?
An end to all conflicts, large and small. Isn't that what you assassins strive for? Peace in all things?
I told you, I'm not an assassin.
Right, right.
I still don't see where I fit into things.
In time, Mr. Miles. In time, you'll understand. Or you won't. I don't care either way, as long as you show us where it is.
Where what is?
Sorry, I'm late. Ready to go?
Yes, we are.
God damn it! What's the problem now?
I'm getting weird temperature readings. I think the Animus is overheating.
Christ, it's always something!
How long?
Too soon to tell.
These delays are unacceptable, Miss Stillman. I want progress reports every hour.
It's gonna be a while, Desmond. Why don't you go lie down or something? Get some rest.
Why is he always yelling at you? It's his machine.
His theories. He's not the one who built it.
Who did? You?
No. Abstergo has a team of engineers. Not much they don't have. But I did oversee the assembly. Guess that's why he gets so angry with me.
He's a dick.
He's under a lot of pressure. We all are.
I can't believe you're defending the guy.
Warren saved my life, so if he wants to yell a little, let him.
What do you mean he saved your life?
You're not the only one who doesn't get to go home at night.
Wait, are you saying you're a prisoner?
When they first approached me, I was finishing up my PhD. The university had made it clear I had no future there. They didn't like the subject of my doctorate, called it pseudoscience. Said keeping me on would discredit and embarrass them. It was the same everywhere. Other universities, companies I interviewed with. Pretty soon I was out of money and out of time. I was this close to waiting tables. Then I got a letter.
From Vidic?
He said he'd been following my career since undergrad, that he believed in my work and wanted to meet to discuss my future. You have no idea how good it felt to hear that. So I met with him. What did I have to lose?
And he offered you a job?
Yes, here at Abstergo, helping out on the Animus project. I'd have a chance to test my theories and prove the professor's wrong. How could I turn that down?
I think I'm missing the part where you became a prisoner.
Sometimes I wonder if they weren't behind it all. If they manipulated events so that I'd get desperate. They can do that. They can do anything. I didn't think when I agreed to come here. They even told me I'd be trapped. For 6 months, a year max. Once the product launched, there'd be no need for secrecy anymore. But until then, I'd be a guest of the company. At least, that's what they said.
And when the Animus was ready?
They came in while I was sleeping. Three guys. Guns. They dragged me out of bed. God. The worst part is I knew them. One guy, Richard, we ate lunch together sometimes. And now he was gonna... They were cracking jokes. I tried to pull away. He hit me. And that's when he told me I was going to die.
Christ, what did you
do? Nothing. I kept telling myself it wasn't real. And then Warren was there, shouting at them to get away from me. And they listened.
Jesus.
He's not a happy man, Desmond. I wouldn't even say he's a good man, but he saved my life. They never came for me again. And he promised they never would.
You're still stuck here working for these nutjobs.
But I'm alive. Anyway, I really do need to get the Animus repaired. I'll see you tomorrow, Desmond.
Rise and shine! We've got quite a day ahead of us.
You're in a good mood this morning.
Miss Stillman has made some modifications to the Animus. You should be able to remain inside even longer now.
And help you with your treasure hunt.
This is serious business, Mr. Miles. I don't think you fully appreciate the work that Abstergo does.
Maybe because I don't actually know what you people do.
We change the world. Every day, in 100 different ways. Did you know that nearly every single breakthrough of the past millennia, be it medical, mechanical, or philosophical, has come from Abstergo or its predecessors?
That's a bold claim, Doc. Think you might be exaggerating a bit?
Not in the slightest. Oh, we certainly don't take the credit. That would arouse far too much suspicion. We choose our beneficiaries with great care.
Why?
Isn't it obvious? It means we're in control.
But how? What makes you guys so special, so smart, that you happen to invent all these things while us mere mortals stumble around like idiots?
To be fair, we don't invent them. We find them.
Find them?
They're gifts, Mr. Miles. From those who came before.
We'll have to continue this discussion later. Time's wasting.
You done already?
Get up.
Whatever you say, Doc.
I'm ending the session. No, I'll be right there. You're sure about this? Yes. No. Everything's Denver. I don't see how he could... Of course. I understand. You're in a lot of trouble, Mr. Miles.
What's his problem?
They're coming for you.
Who's coming for me?
Assassins.
Hey, I had nothing to do with this.
Sounds like they're mounting some kind of rescue attempt. Guess you're more important than you realized.
Man, things just keep getting weirder and weirder around here.
It was bound to happen.
What do you mean?
That little fight your ancestor started during the Third Crusade, it never ended. You're being held by Templars.
Vidic's a Templar?
There's no way you could have known. They hide it so well. But to answer your question, Vidic works for them. We all do. Abstergo is their company.
I thought Templars were old dudes with funny hats who sat around drinking beer and plotting world domination with, like, the lizard people.
No. Except the part about world domination, I guess. Look, Desmond, it's complicated. Half the stuff they say about the Templars comes from crazy tinfoil hat-wearing nutjobs. The other half is misinformation intentionally produced by the Templars themselves.
But they are the bad guys, right?
If there's one thing I've learned since I started working here, it's that there's no such thing. It's all so relative. I guess the best way to explain it is, what they want is good, but the way they're going about it, it's bad. Really bad.
What are they trying to do? Lucy.
Yes.
Miss Dillon, I need to speak with you. Get up here, now.
On my way, Doctor. I'm sorry, Desmond, I have to go. You should turn in for the night. The answers to all of your questions are right in front of you. You just have to know where to look.
Missed you this morning, Doc.
Get in the Animus.
Not a lot of time, Vidic.
Understand there's a narrow launch window.
Wherever it's hidden, time to retrieve it.
Working on it.
And when it's done,
he'll be taken care of.
I want that progress report by tomorrow morning.
I've got some work I need to do. So you've got the rest of the night to yourself.
I think there's a problem with the Animus.
Nope. It's working fine.
I'm pretty sure it just ejected me when
I'm pretty sure you should shut up.
You ready to finally tell me what's going on?
We have to stop them, Desmond. When they access that last memory of yours, they're just getting started. They want to change everything. The way we live, the way we think, the way we are. You've gotten the lecture from Vidic about what's wrong with the world, how we need order and discipline, so they're going to give it to us. Only we don't have a say in the matter.
How?
The Templar treasure. They think it...
Miss Stillman?
I'm here.
I need you to upload Desmond's files to the database.
Got it.
So what? You're using me to find this Templar treasure? What do they call it? The Peace of Eden?
Yes.
Well, it's looking like it's at Messiah. So I don't know why they're wasting all this time with me. Why don't they just send their people to pick it up?
They can't. It's not that simple. The artifact from Messiah, they had it. It was destroyed in the accident.
Then what are they hoping for me? You know, for my ancestor, to tell them?
They're hoping he'll show them where the other ones are.
You mean there's more than one of these things?
Oh, Desmond, you have no idea.
Is there a problem, Mr.
No, Warren. Everything's Denver on my end.
Then, where are the files?
I've got to move these files before he gets suspicious. We'll talk more later.
Wait, what's that mean, everything's Denver?
It means everything's fine.
Why Denver?
It's a reference to Denver International Airport. There's an underground facility there. It's where the accident happened.
Time's wasting, Mr. Miles.
Yeah, I'm coming.
We're nearly done, you know.
And then what?
You'll see. Maybe they'll even let you watch when it begins. It's not as terrible as you think.
Look, I know you're not gonna let me leave. So why not tell me what's going on? Humor me.
I'm not an idiot, Mr. Miles. I think you've already learned quite a bit.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Of course not.
All right, let me ask you something else then.
Yes?
Some of the stuff I'm seeing in the Animus, sometimes it seems wrong. Untrue, like the history is off somehow. It doesn't...
It doesn't what, Mr. Miles? Match up with what you read on an online encyclopedia? What your high school history teacher taught you? Let me ask you something. Do these supposed experts have access to secret knowledge kept hidden from the rest of us?
There are books, letters, documents, all sorts of source material from back then. Some of it seems to contradict what the Animus is showing me.
Anyone can write a book, and they can put whatever they want on its pages. Anything. Used to be we thought the world was flat.
Some people still do.
Yes, and they publish books about it. Or that the moon landing was a hoax. I believe there's also a book claims the world was created in 7 days. A bestseller, too.
Where's this going, Doc?
The point, I suppose, is that you shouldn't trust everything you hear, everything you read. What's that your ancestors said? Nothing is true.
Everything is permitted.
Yes, exactly. It's part of what makes the Animus so spectacular. There's no room for misinterpretation.
There's always room.
Touché, Mr. Miles. Now that I've answered your question, can we begin?
We have much...
I said get up, goddammit! Listen!
Oh no.
Seems your assassin friends found us.
What?
How'd you do it, Desmond?
Hey, look, I don't know what you're talking about, but whatever's going on down there has got nothing to do with me.
They're here for you, and I sure as shit didn't invite them. What's the situation down there?
We're taking heavy fire.
Can you contain it, or do I need to evacuate the prisoner?
Only 5 or 6. We've got them outnumbered. Couple of wounded, but we'll pull through. We'll get it under control.
God damn you, Desmond. You couldn't leave well enough alone.
I told you I had nothing to do with this. How would I even contact them? Telepathy? Come on!
Doesn't matter. They'll be dead soon enough. Here, have a listen.
It's been neutralized.
Looks like the cavalry won't be coming.
Dunno, Doc. You're freaking out a minute ago. Your little research facility not as secure as you thought it was? Worried they'll be back with more?
I don't think so, Desmond.
What Lucy here is trying to say is that there aren't any assassins left to come for you. We've been very busy this past year, hunting down your little enclaves, your desert communes and whatnot. I'm afraid you're on your own. Rest up, Mr. Miles. Tomorrow, we finish this.
I'm sorry, Desmond.
You mentioned the desert. Do you think...
They sent a team there, but the place was deserted. I don't know where your parents are, and I can't promise they're still alive. But I think they got away.
Thanks. Thanks for checking.
It's not as bad as it seems.
What are you talking about? They just killed, literally killed, my only chance of getting out of here. And then I find out the assassins are all but destroyed, and Christ, I still don't know what these people are planning. But I do know they plan to kill me when they're done. I am screwed, okay? What do you want me to do?
Just try and have a little faith.
You're...
Have faith. Rest up, Desmond. You're gonna need the energy.
Get up!
Even earlier than usual, Doc.
I'd like to get this over with as quickly as possible.
If you say so.
Don't be so glum, Mr. Miles. Today is a historic day. One that will be remembered for years to come. Remembered by some of us, anyway.
What the hell was that?
Well?
We've got the map.
How many?
At least 6.
We don't need them all.
We should assume some amount of decay. I can't imagine they'll all still be functioning. At least 2 appear to reside on landmasses that no longer exist.
We'll dispatch teams to each site and determine viability. We only need 1, after all.
What about the rest?
Collect them. Let's not leave anything to chance. Last thing we need is some damn survivor making trouble for us in the new world.
And the assassin?
We have what we need. Kill him.
Wait. You know how these things work. I doubt we'll be able to walk right in.
What's your point?
We might need him. His memories. I'd recommend we hold him until we have confirmation that there aren't any surprises waiting for us at the sites.
This is a waste of time.
You said it yourself. We shouldn't leave anything to chance.
Very well. Ensure we have no further need of him, then kill him.
Fine. Stop undermining my authority!
I just saved your ass.
Let's go. We've got a lot of work to do. Don't get too comfortable, Mr. Miles. We'll be back for you soon enough.
Oh my God. Looks like... is that blood? The hell were they keeping here before me? And what happened to him? What does it mean, I wonder?